Hi guys, this is Joe here from Rufioh. Welcome to the channel. For today's video, we're going to be taking a look at some of my favourite TCG sets ever printed. Predominantly, we're going to be looking at core sets and some side sets here. We're not going to be looking at a lot of reprint stuff like dual power and that kind of thing. I just wanted to focus on my favourite booster sets that we've seen in the game. Of course, this is an opinion piece, so if you don't agree with me, feel free to rip me a new one. Or, of course, I'd love to hear down in the comments exactly what you think about what the best sets are in the game. If you agree, if you disagree, I'd love to hear it all. As a kind of quick note, these aren't in any particular order. They are just whatever came to mind and sort of shoved out there on a nice script for me to remember to read. Before we continue, though, you should definitely hit subscribe so you don't miss out on this kind of absolute fucking garbage in future. Or, you know, don't. The choice is yours. But either way, thank you very much for joining me. We're going to get stuck into the video and I'm going to stop waffling absolute bollocks at the camera. So we start off today by talking about Magic Ruler, or Spell Ruler as it was later known. This is a set that really does fly under the radar when you hear people talking about impactful sets, but this set had so many insane cards printed, power spells that are still rightfully hindered on the list in some way. The set had a number of wild cards, including the likes of Forceful Sentry, Delinquent Duo, Snatch Steel, Upstart Goblin, Giant Trunade, Mystical Space Typhoon, Painful Choice, and the hilarious Cyberjar. Following on from that, we have IOC, Invasion of Chaos. This is arguably one of the most defining sets the game has ever seen. And we could really go into a lot of details about how and why that happened, but that could quite easily be a whole other video in and of itself. Put simply though, we saw the likes of Dark Magician of Chaos and Chaos Sorcerer enter the game, but more prominently the likes of Blackluster Soldier, Envoy the Beginning, which dominated the game for formats to come. And of course, who could forget the most notorious monster of all time, Chaos Emperor Dragon, Envoy of the End. Maximum Crisis. This is one of those weird sets that has more and more value the more you look. On the surface, you have some of the more obvious bits, Ash Blossom and Joyous Spring, the True Draco cards, the True King cards, some Zodiac bad boys, but then you dig a little deeper and there's plenty of gems. Set Rotation, Spiral Support, Supreme King Donut, Dark Worm, Noodle, the Predaplant Twins, Tornado Dragon, and who could forget, Mild Turkey and Ghost Beef. Light of Destruction. Okay, so there's probably some bias going on here with Lightsworn being my all-time favourite deck, and Light of Destruction was the first ever sealed box I got to open for myself, which I got as judge support, and luckily, pulled a Ghost Honest. Ball bias aside, Lightsworn has seen competitive play to some degree in many formats ever since its release in Light of Destruction. Granted, much of the power has come from later waves, but the deck has remained strong. Beyond that, we've also got cards that are often not thought about with this set, such as Substitoad, Fossil Dino Pachycephalo, and Demise of the Land. Lord of the Tachyon Galaxy. For those of you not familiar with this set, you can find support for a variety of cool archetypes in this set. The likes of Atlantean, Constella, Evil Swarm, Mermail, Spellbook, Harpies, the list goes on. But this support isn't what made this set so insane. It's the debutants that do. LTGY introduced Mecha Phantom Beasts into the TCG, which is pretty cool, but then it went ahead and brought about the reign of the notorious Dragon Rulers, which still today aren't completely available to the game in general, with Konami only having been brave enough to bring Tempest off the list at the time of recording this video. Dragon Rulers went on to be one of the most insanely overpowered decks ever concocted, rinsing tournaments after tournaments, up until they got absolutely splattered off the face of the game. The set also saw Battling Boxers get their debut too, but nobody really gives a shit about them. When you talk about Duelist Alliance, you'll see countless players' faces light up, with some of the formats following this being regarded extremely highly amongst competitive players. DUEA saw the introduction of a number of top-notch decks into the TCG, but the obvious ones worth mentioning here have to absolutely go to the likes of Shadol, Telenite, Yangzing, and the TCG exclusive Burning Abyss. All of these still have some sort of pocket of cult following in the game, even still today. If you've ever seen someone involved with trying to make some money off of a set, they usually don't come much better than the likes of Flames of Destruction. But that's not why it makes it to this list. We saw all kinds of insane cards printed, staples such as Red Reboot, Call by the Grave, Ghost Spell, Trisbaner, Sekka's Light, Infinite Impermanence, Vampire Sucker, Multifaker, Goki Things, and more. Flood, most prominently of all though, introduced the Nightmare archetype, something of a staple for extra decks for the entire Master Rule and even still seeing play today. A set of utility cards that are easily accessible from the extra deck, largely very budget friendly and incredibly diverse. And who can forget the absolutely stupid Nightmare Goblin, the first ever Link monster to have been banned, although we really know that should have gone to Firewall Dragon. Order of Chaos. There's a number of awesome cards that got printed into this set, but we can go ahead and basically disregard anything that doesn't say Inzektor or Windup printed on them. With the set debuting the Inzektor archetype and providing even more support for the Windup. These two decks have gone on to be two of the most successful and loved decks the game has ever produced, and for that reason, ORCS deserves a lot more love and respect. Dark Saviors. Unless you've been living under some kind of rock since 2018, you'll already know where this is heading. Sky Striker was brought into the format during Dark Saviors, a deck that was fair and balanced from the get-go. Well, maybe not. As a deck, it's one of the most successful and decorated archetypes in the game's history, being so malleable that every time it got hit, every time the meta shifted to try and deal with it, it would adapt. And even now still has a strong cult following, mostly simps of course. Although the most skilled of pilots are still able to control and dominate matches with the deck, despite all the hits to its consistency, and boy was it consistent. Every time you sat down at an event and thought, ah nice, my opponent isn't playing a deck that's Sky Striker, they just drop that engage, search that Hornet drones, and go about their merry fucking business. Whether it is an engine or a full on deck, Sky Striker will go down as one of the most insane decks the game has ever seen. The New Challengers. Very appropriately named, the New Challengers saw a ton of new support come across already great archetypes such as Shadol, Yangzing, Telenites, Burning Abyss, and more. We also got Fry from Fluffles, but most prominently, we saw the introduction of an insanely meta-relevant Klee, who slotted perfectly into the game and in fact decided to just go ahead and warp the entire meta and offered a new option outside of those that already debuted in Duelist Alliance, making for an incredibly diverse metagame. Pharaonic Guardian. Another fantastic set that sometimes feels a little bit underappreciated. We did get to see some absolutely insanely relevant cards printed in this set, many of them having been banned and or errated at some point since their release. Some of these even remain on the list to this very day. Some of the most notable cards from the set include Ring of Destruction, Donzalug, Book of Moon, Spirit Reaper, Reasoning, Necrovalley, Terraforming, Lava Golem, Trap Dust Shoot, and finally Nightmare Wheel. Raging Tempest is another booster pack that has some really cool cards in its set, with support for an absolute shit ton of different decks, but we can safely ignore all of those and just talk about Zodiac. Zodiac is a deck that either puts the fear of God into players or makes them smile. Regardless of which side of the Zodiac love-hate train you fall onto, we know that even still today, Konami are scared of us giving them at full power again, and for good reason. Remember Sky Strikers that we talked about earlier? Zoo was into similar sorts of shenanigans. They've actually started creeping back into the metagame over the last few months, at least at the time of recording this video, and we could well see a resurgence once we have the remaining Tri Brigade cards drop into the TCG. Keep an eye on these ones. The Duelist Genesis. This set gave us the likes of Stardust, which saw play for years after its initial release, Red Dragon Archfiend, and plenty of other awesome cards. But the real excitement stems from the direct and indirect support cards that came out from this set, as well as the debut of the Psychic-type monsters. Amongst other things, we got the likes of Krebons, the now-banned Mindmaster, the now-ruined Goya Guardian, Thought Ruler Archfiend, Emergency Teleport, Charger Light Brigade, and much more. You don't get that much value from a set very often. And of course, we have saved the best for last, at least in my opinion. Phantom Darkness took the already powerful Dark Attribute monsters, pumped them full of steroids, and then proceeded to break the game in its entirety. Phantom Darkness ushered in an era of literal darkness for pretty much anybody who tried to play the game a different way. Some of the most expensive decks in history followed on, cards that got abused in this era have been on and off the list ever since, and skewed the game in favour of the Dark Attribute to no end, something that still lingers in the modern game. Some of the cards in this set people probably forget were even printed, with the likes of Lone Fire Blossom, Sansara Lotus, Super Poly, and Cyber Valley. But of course we also have the notorious quartet of Allure of Darkness, the Brothers of Destruction, and the game-warping Dark Armed Dragon. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed the video. By the fact that you've made it this far into the video, I assume you have. In either case, thank you very much for coming along. If you're looking to pick up any singles for the TCG as a whole, you should check out Jam Jam Cards UK. Link is in the description. They are the channel sponsors. If you hit them up, you might get yourself a nice discount if you let them know that I sent you. Thank you very much for coming along. If you haven't already, you should definitely hit subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.
This content is brought to you in association with my buddies over at Jam Jam Cards UK. You can find the links to the eBay store and the Facebook page in the description.